My name is Marshall Corso. I'm a senior. I like to yo-yo. I was introduced to yo-yoing by mainly my friends. I saw them doing it and I said to myself, oh, that looks kind of cool. So I just picked one up and tried it.
This is my first yo-yo that I got, basically. And it's called the Yoyo Factory Skyline.
I've been yo-yoing since sophomore year. So I've been yo-yoing for about 2.5 years.
These three are all Yoyo Factory, which is pretty much the biggest company out there right now. This is one that was released when they were smaller. These two are from a company called Caribou Lodge. It's a CLYW, or Caribou Lodge Yoyo Works.
They're based in Canada, hence the name.
But this one is called the Avalanche. This is what the box goes to. This one's called the Sasquatch, but this is a special edition. This is called the Burnside. These two are from a company called One Drop, which is based in Oregon. Oh, by the way, these two companies are like really pretty small. And this is called the Rally. This one is considered a budget performance yo-yo. It'll perform sort of similarly to your metal yo-yos, but it maybe will lack feel. Almost every yo-yo now will unscrew. They have ball bearings, and this is what allows it to actually have long spin time. If it didn't have this, they'd probably only spin for like 10 seconds. There's also this squishy rubber on the sides. And this is to catch the string. They're called response pads, and it catches the string so the string will actually roll up.
So right now we're driving to the Yoyo Factory.
My name is Tyler and I am 22 years old. I work for a yo-yo manufacturer called Yoyo Factory. I've been yo-yoing for 15 years and at Yoyo Factory I organize promotional tours and I do school demonstrations and teach kids how to yo-yo and have a signature series of yo-yos. I compete professionally. I do a lot of different things at Yoyo Factory.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Garcia. I'm a professional yo-yoer and I teach kids at schools and at classes every weekend.
Here's where a lot of the graphic design goes on. Making of catalogs or promotional items. A lot of artwork is up here. We have old yo-yos and we still make these. Some of them are prototypes, so ones that we made before we started producing them. A lot of these ones are really expensive or one of a kind. A lot of different colorways. This one's one of our most expensive Catch 22 yo-yos that came in a pelican case. And there's all different kinds of yo-yos, looping yo-yos, unresponsive yo-yos.
My favorite yo-yo is called the Yoyo Factory Supernova. Right after I won the World Yo-Yo Contest, I actually got to design a pro model for this company called Spy. And what happened was, I didn't really know what I wanted to make a yo-yo play the way it is. Like, there's all different little intricacies of like how it's designed here and there, and like the way it's shaped, how it would fly through the air, and like the weight is here in the middle, so like it's gonna play really heavy versus like there's all these different details that go into it. And like I wasn't super analytical at the time, and I just looked at other yo-yos I liked and tried to mash a bunch together. But like anything with time, you get better. And like fortunately, Yoyo Factory constantly over and over again is like, oh, let's make you another pro model. And I think I've had like 7 or 8 different pro models that I've got to design with Yoyo Factory now.
Hi, I'm Boyd Seth, professional yo-yo player, work at Yoyo Factory, sponsored by Caribou Lodge, conflict of interest. And I've been yo-yoing for about 10 years. I'm about right. Laser beam hits it several mirrors, pulls out, and if it's in focus, it heats up the anodize and pretty much bleaches the mark into the yo-yo. I'll take a little bit to heat up.
So it can do like all of these spaces all at one time?
Correct. Everything on this side of the warehouse is sellable goods. You can see our shelves are pretty empty because people buy a lot of yo-yos, so that's what the container's coming in to fulfill all these shelves. And you can see we have feeding products sitting on here. Pretty fun environment. Those yo-yos and work hard. All sorts of stuff. Got some ricochets. Retail $200. Titanium. Pretty cool. They make a great spark on the ground. Or walk the dog.
Pretty much it.
Really expensive trick.
These are some light up yo-yos.
And here we keep our parts, bearings, upstacks, axles. Plenty of axles and bearings. As you can see, pads, caps, Z-stacks, and then packaging. These are all of our cards. Put in the yo-yos. There you go, Silver Series. And old cards in there too. There's something called the Playbook. That's a really cool book. You know, there's modern looping and classic tricks. It tells you how to tie a knot, how to cut the string. QR codes that take you to product video and trick videos. And after every section, if you can beat it, you get a stamp, and then you also get that. And if you can collect all three, you get the 100% player when you finish the whole book. So it's a really neat thing. It helps you get started.
So do you just like hand those out at events to
Oh, we do. Sometimes it's promotional where it goes to a customer and then maybe they're trying to start a yo-yo club or it's incentive. Maybe a kid will buy a yo-yo if you can learn how to play it. It's just to help kids learn how to use it properly.
I really love working with kids. I hate to like get all cheesy and like I'm influencing the next generation, but like I really like my ultimate goal is to get more kids yo-yoing, because like when I was a kid I didn't like sports, like I didn't like relying on other people, because like anytime you relied on other people they told you have to wait, you have to do this, you have to take this path that everyone else is taking. And like when I was on my own I could always make it work on my own somehow, and I would always do like something that no one ever told me how to do or no one ever gave me an idea or thought of how to do. So like I really try to encourage kids to do that. Like in the same visit I will always tell all those kids too, like you all better go to college and like it's really difficult in the real world, so like don't just think you can go like play Xbox all day and that's gonna work. Like I yo-yoed for 10 years and put, you know, 20,000 hours into this. Like I could have like a PhD in this by now, but like I don't know. So I really like working with kids, but ultimately like it's about getting new people involved, and that's why I like working with kids the most. Like they have the most to offer the world. They're not tainted yet. They don't know what's really gonna happen, or they don't know how bad things really are, so they can just run with it. They look at it as like what it really is, a toy, and they have a lot of fun. So